processional for our honorees on this evening. Pastor Arthur Ray Sledge and First Lady Missionary Lisa Marie Sledge. Amen.
Yeah. scripture by Elder Jerome Sledge. New Testament scripture by Elder Frank Phillips. We'll go in this order. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
you, God, for your word in which we are about to receive in a few minutes, God. Thank you for being your people that have to assemble themselves together to praise your name and to be a blessing to the honor of you today. Help us to stand, God. Help us to stand right now. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. God, we give you praise and we give you thanks. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Thank God.
Thank God.
Amen.
Amen. The church say amen. 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 Yes, Mr. Richard, come from the class, the fourth chapter, 9th through the 11th verse. It reads, two are better than one. Yes. Because they have a good reward, yes, for their labor. But if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow. Yes. But woe to him that is alone when he falls, for he had not another to help him up. Yes. Again, if two lie together, then they have heart. But how can one be worn alone? Amen. May God be a blessing in the reading of his word. Amen.
Man, read it in your hearing.
Hallelujah.
10th chapter of Romans. 14 to 15 verse. But whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord,
yes,
shall be saved.
Yes.
How then shall they call on his name whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher?
Yes.
In the 15th, let's see. And how shall they preach except they be sent?
Uh-huh.
As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel.
Amen.
Peace and bring glad tidings of good things.
Yes.
May Lord help us to read.
Amen. Now we have songs of praise by missionary Bama Ballard, Sister Doris Spears, and Sister Para Lumona. Let's receive them by saying amen.
Amen.
Yeah!
Pastor Naimuna, amen. Both of those sons of praise, amen. Give him another hand, amen. Amen, amen. That brings us up to a welcome from Missionary Thelma Brandon. Following her will be a selection from the Children's Sunshine Purity and Youth Department. Followed by a response from Sister Brenda Black. Let's come into the Lord, amen. Let's see during the word of amen.
Amen. As I stand before you on today, we are honored to have you as our special guest. Each and every one of you, you're our guests. First, I would like to say we invite you on today, on this 26th year, Pastor and wife has served faithfully. Secondly, I would like to invite you because you are in love country here at Keybridge. When we come together, we fellowship, we worship, and we praise the Lord. So on today, to all of you, you are welcome here at Keybridge.
Thank you. Of the bride of Christ, you will always be to me.
What you mean to this church and to each and every life. We are so thankful that you chose Jesus to be our pastor's wife. You just want to be a blessing, and that you have been. If the pastor of us had to choose, we both choose you again.
Last time,
but she so freely showed love, Praise God. And so I just thank God for her. She's my joy. She's my heart. Praise God. I love Lisa Marie. You all pray for us that we'll be that family that God wants us to be. We're supposed to be a light in the dark.
Right.
Praise God. Amen. I thank God for this family. And I ask you all to pray for me, and I'll do you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I thank God for all of you. Amen. But I rose to pay tribute for a moment to my pastor. Amen. None other than the one and only Elder Arthur Ray Sledge. Amen.
Amen.
A great man of God. A great anointed man of God. Anointed man of God that when he preaches, results follows. Because I don't believe that if you are preaching to the man of God, there should be some results behind your ministry.
Amen.
And he is a great man of God. He's a great leader. He's an inspirator. Amen. He's a man of God that's leading Keegan to higher heights. Amen. To greater depths. Amen. He's a man of God that's not scared of a change for the better. Amen. Amen. He's not scared of the future. Amen. Because if we don't watch it, we'll get left behind. As a denomination, as a church, and other people. Amen. So he's a man of God that's willing, amen, to listen, amen, to ideals. Amen. Because even though we're men of God, hey, God gives other people revelation too. Amen. So don't think he just delivered to us. Amen. But he's a great man of God, and he's a humble man. He's a very humble man. He's a man I respect so much. He's a man that blessed me to come in up under his wings. I have learned so much. The main thing I learned is being humble and love. Amen. Being humble and love. Those two men that go a long way. Being humble and love. And then he's a man that I respect so much. I tell you, I gained his respect one day when he was talking to me and another minister about us stepping out into ministry. He told us, I said, yeah, Pastor. I said, yeah, we've been watching you. Yeah, we see. I did not the eyes across the teeth. He said, yeah, let me tell you one thing, though. He said, don't make the same mistake I made. Amen. Ain't too many men of God gonna admit that, ain't gonna say that. But we all miss God, or halfway miss God, or don't wanna follow the whole route of God. Amen. But he told me that, and I tell you what, it gained my respect. Because I'm gonna tell you something. I was down there sitting up under somebody said they ain't never made a mistake or missed God. Now, you said that was a spirit of the devil walking up. That definitely a spirit of the devil. Right there, because we gon' all sometimes mother miss God. But when it comes from a man or woman of God that are missing mistakes, everybody miss. We miss, hey, we do it. But it means so much. And you touch lives to let people know leaders like him and Sister Marie. Sister Marie Flair, Lisa. They inspire you. They inspire you when they let you know that you don't have to be perfect. And you're not going to be perfect. You know, that's what I think that's wrong with a lot of us, you know, a lot of people in ministry, they expect for us to be perfect. And just like our kids, I tell you what, a whole lot of us ain't got the wheels made for the kids to have a bunch of ourselves out there. That's my pastor. I tell you what, I just love him. And I tell you what, anything I can do for him. Him and First Lady, they was there when my mother went to the hospital. I was going to hard time. They always been there for everybody, each and every one in this church. I can vouch for that. And they're worthy. They're worthy of everything that they get. They're worthy of everything. And I tell you what, like I said, Pastor, love you, appreciate you. Not only he's a pastor, he's a father, he's a grandfather, he's a assistant superintendent of the church. He's a supporter of the brotherhood. I tell you, he wears many hats. Amen. And I tell you what, it's just an honor, amen, to be able to watch somebody spiritually walk line upon line and precept upon precept and let the word of God be final authority in their lives. You know, ain't too many to do that. The word of God being final authority in your life. Amen. Now, I tell you what, Pastor Sledge, Sister Marie, as I always said, Lisa, you two are winning prayer. I tell you what, y'all are winning prayer. And we just all love you. And in a minute, when it comes offering time, we're gonna put that in action. Okay? Somebody's gonna show me the money, huh?
Amen. I'm going to MC for my girls right now, amen. But we all have a selection from the Kedron Choir. Amen.
We're winners now.
We're winners.
thank each and every one of you for those tributes. Ooh, I ain't young no more, y'all. I'm out of breath. But I'm moving, and that's all that matters. God gives me strength. Of guests by missionary. Verse 3, then we will have expressions by our own superintendent of the Rising Fellowship District, Superintendent E. Lee. We will have offer of prayer by Elder Timothy Spears. And then we will have expedited offering with Elder Will Brown, and we will have the finance committee for the offering. Let's receive each of them in that order, please. Praise God. It is truly an honor and a pleasure for me to stand before you today on behalf of my pastor and all the members of the Kingdom to say thank you and to recognize you on today. You all make a great, beautiful bouquet. You all are jewels in the crown of God that He's going to give you one day. And I see faces, and I don't know who's pastoring, and then I don't know the name of the church. So y'all help me out today. We would like to thank and honor and just recognize our guest speaker today from Grapevine Church of God in Christ, Elder Lawrence Hart and Lady Hawes. Please stand. We're trying to hold your applause to the end, and we're going to give everybody a hand because we are glad to see you today. Thank you. Harris Temple Memorial Church of God in Christ, Superintendent E.B. Lee and Lady Lee. Swindon Church of God in Christ, Elder Jerome Sledge and Lady Sledge, and members. Please, members, if you're here, please stand. Tate Stanford Church of God in Christ, Elder Frank Phillips and Lady Phillips, and members. Elder Timothy Spears, the Word Lives Church of God in Christ, and Lady Spears. Victory Church of God in Christ, Superintendent John Oliver and Lady Oliver and members. Amen. True Believers Church of God in Christ, Elder Martin Martin and Lady Martin and members.
Amen.
Greenlee Baptist Church, New Edinburgh, Pastor Clara Morgan. Walker's Temple Church of God in Christ, Pastor Kyle Bird and Lady Bird as a member. And well, I see that we have Elder Souls and Lady Souls, but I don't know the name of your church. I see part of Union Grove here. I don't know who's pastoring that now. Okay, I'm so sorry. I'm kidding. Please have the soldiers and members stay. I'm not picking on you, but we're glad to have you today. Yes, I just walked all over there. Elder Phillip, you forgive me. Patilla Memorial Church of God in Christ, Parkland, Arkansas. Elder Nikki Phillips and Lady Phillips.
Thank you. I love it.
Come on. Victory. Is there anybody else?
Yeah.
On behalf of Keaton Church of God in Christ, and the pastor do his own things, but I'm thanking you. We as the members, we are so glad that you came out today.
Amen.
You know, when it comes to anniversary, we just kind of go. believe y'all love Pastor Sledge. Bring you here today for such a great occasion. And again, I said, we the members said we thank you and we appreciate you to all our guests on today. I salute you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen, amen. Now we have our very own Superintendent E.B. Lee, amen. Let's all just say, God bless.
God bless.
Superintendent Lee.
Superintendent Lee.
Amen. Amen. Let's praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
God is good, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Amen. Certainly it's a blessing to be in the house this evening.
Amen.
Amen. We want to honor you. Amen. Man that chosen by God to be a pastor. Amen. Some is made pastor. And some born pastor. I feel like Ella Sledge were born. Amen. Because I've been knowing it down through the years. You always
when you
come up on the Lord's side. He's a holy man. And when God chooses a man, like some he's a chosen man. Chosen. Amen. There's a difference. And some that have the deal of preaching, but they're not chosen. Ella Sledge, amen, I think about years back as we worked in Georgia City. He was one of the pastors that the people respected. Wasn't no lots of pastors out there that people respected. But Ella Sledge, amen, God called him and chosen him and sent him. We see that his work, his father. Amen. Always need to be some signs behind the pastor. Amen. Even back in the days of Apostle Paul here, the signs followed him. Amen. And we, as pastors, signs follow us. Sometimes people say, well, I don't believe he called. So many called, but a few chosen. Then a lot of people that ain't called ain't chosen, but they called. Amen. A lot of them cut up. I respect the assistant superintendent and the life that he lived, and also respect his wife and knowing her. But not only that, amen, when I was at the Eurasian, you know, amen, I pastored Brotherhood Creed, that was your day. Amen, praise God. That man, you a happy man. He would always just shout in church, you know, and it's good to, amen, to have joy in your life. I was looking at the service and somehow some of those happy, you know, dancing. It's good to dance. It's good to dance because that's a part of it. Yeah. Amen. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Right. If you don't have no joy, you ain't got much strength. Yeah. Amen. You may not dance like Brother Sledge, no matter. God will give you a dance. Yeah. Amen. And certainly we thank God for these pastors. Amen. The speaker this evening, Ella Hall. Yeah. Amen. All the pastors here. Amen. Ministers of God and missionaries. Thank God for Sister Slater. This is pretty missionary. Yeah. She called her name what?
Lolo.
Lolo? Your name. Marie what?
Marie.
I don't know if she knows. We know what God is. Amen. The church is some flowers. She's some flowers. Amen. Certainly, God is a good God. And Ella Sledge, amen. I can say things about him because of truth.
Right.
Now, me, if you've been a crook, and you still a crook, don't call me to tell all the good stuff. Don't put me up in something good about you. Let's not tell somebody so. I just tell what I like about you. I'm not going to tell if you're going to try to hurt somebody. But I believe that a man should be a what you you fight your wife and go on home. I ain't gonna be talking to you. You fucking wife. I can't sit there and check you. God look at us. Amen. Thank God for it. Sonny Ellis said you done a beautiful job. Amen. I enjoyed preaching. He's a preacher. He's a gifted preacher. And he lived a life. I think about how you come down here so many times a week and pray. And, see, prayer changes things. God looking for some faithful people. And he's been faithful to this church. Amen. He built the church. Amen. And some are talking about the old church has some sealed place for them to be all profit up and stuff. The old slave, God had taken him to be. And he still got to be. He is the chief of this church. Isn't that right? The other guy, the deacon, you deacon. But this man is over the church.
Yes,
and God going to be with him.
Yes,
and if you don't want nothing bad to happen to you, you don't mess with a man of God.
That's right.
You don't mess with a man of God. And we are saints of God. We love God.
Yes.
And you love God, people. I want to see a man trying to live
yes.
right. I don't want to see a man out there just during everything and just talking about you can't do, you can't live prayer.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, yeah. But in Matthew 5 and 48 says,
well,
be told in sight, be perfect as your Father in heaven is perfect.
Right.
You ain't going to be perfect if you don't try to be. Oh, that's right. God wants somebody. That's why I'm here today.
Yeah.
I could have been out there. I didn't have to come back. I was dead.
Yeah.
I felt the breath when it went out of my body. But God brought me back.
Yeah.
God brought me back. He don't want us to be different. The church of God in Christ, he wants us to be strong.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
That's what Jesus said, fear the man that's able to kill your body.
Yes.
Put your soul in hell.
That's right.
Don't worry about nobody don't do something to his body.
That's
but
right.
Certainly God is good. In the day, hear me say
it's evening.
We want to do a good job.
Yes.
We want to show some love to superintendent slave.
Yes.
Which is the sister superintendent of the rider. Fellowship history.
Yeah.
I helped all kinds of people. All you do is get up and preach. You need preaching to them. You're the dog in the hall. You need preaching to
them.
Uh-huh.
That's why
I said, so God is on my side.
Yeah.
You're always going to be on the righteous man's side.
Yeah.
You ain't got to go out and try to get done for somebody. You live right, God will set you up.
Yeah.
You'll set you up? Never said, I praise the Lord. I thank God for you. I just look around and see how that you are blessed. It's been a blessing to this church in your preaching. In your preaching. And how you all have just beautified the church.
Yeah.
Amen. People working with you.
Yeah.
Got some compound blood down here. You do anyway. But God is a good God.
Yes.
And you keep on living right as missionary slaves.
Yeah. I'm September.
Hey.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
We got a job to do.
Yeah.
We.
All right.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And we just thank God for it. Just be open.
Yeah.
We may not have a whole lot of members, but we need those that we have. Tell them the truth. And you can tell why people dress and wear anything they want to wear and go to church. And you come in there, you go pay for it. If it has a, yeah, you pay for it. Because all of us have to pay for it. We know things going on in church, and we know.
And filled with the Holy Ghost. I thank God for what He is in my life, and I do give honor to everyone that's here on this evening. Amen. Thank God for all of these great men of God. Amen. And their companions, and to everyone that's here in the house of the Lord under the sound of my voice. Thank God for my very own aunt. Amen. Who I do love so dearly. Thank God for Aunt Clara. Amen. And certainly, amen, I want to say, first of all, thank you to Kedron for your, amen, love that you have shown to us today. And not only just today, but throughout the year, we appreciate you and all that you do. We realize you don't have to do what you do, but we thank you for your giving, for your, amen, your loving support and your prayers. We love you, Kedron. Thank you. The beautiful gift committee that's probably coming up. I'm just speaking in prophecy now. Amen. Thank God for the decoration, for the food. Amen. And I'm speaking again for the finance. Thank you so much for that. Amen. I just want to say that we thank God for our children. I'm just going to recognize part of the family. If Pastor Lance comes, he'll recognize the other half. Amen. So I thank, first of all, I thank God for our three daughters. I'm going to ask all three of them to stand. We're blessed to have them with us. Amen. Together. And every time they come together, I see my little three girls again. And I'm so blessed. Thank God for Lolita. Keep standing. Until y'all sit down again. Amen. Thank God for my oldest daughter, Lolita, and for the baby girl, Sandy, and for the middle girl, Rikisha. Thank the Lord for them, and thank God for our grandchildren, and that's all over. I'm asking Jalen, the oldest grandchild, to stand, and Maya is in the choir stand, and I got two grandsons somewhere. They in the back. And thank God for my son-in-law. Y'all, we all give my son-in-law a hand, please. Recognize my family, I leave him out. And then I find out on the Beyonce. Then I disobedience, thank the Lord. But then, you know, I leave him out every time, and then when it's over, he comes to me and he'll let me know I forgot him. So before service started today, he met me at the truck when I was getting out. He said, "You better not forget me." I made sure I put that in the back of my mind. Amen. He meant that today. Thank you for my brother. But brother Al, he don't talk very much, but when he does, he says a few powerful things. Thank the Lord for him. Thank God. Amen. For all of my relatives, as you have some cousins here, thank the Lord for them. Amen. And besides the granddaughters and grandson that I mentioned, thank God for little Reagan. This is her first anniversary with us on this year. Amen. Can y'all just give a little Reagan a hand? Amen. She is the angel of our family. We thank God for little Reagan. I call her Reaganade because sometimes she gets a little fussy, and she's a Reaganade. Amen. But certainly we thank God. Amen. Again, for all of my family and friends that's here. Again, I thank God for my aunt. She is, amen, so dear to me. We did grow up together at New Edinburgh, and I did try to follow up everything that she did because I looked up to her and I thought whatever she did was so cool. And then one day God called me my life. Thank God. To God be the glory. Still here. Amen. So I now want to say I thank the Lord for the MCs on today. Amen. Thank the Lord for them. Done an awesome job also on today. And everyone that took part on the program, thank you for what you've done. The tribute and everything that you've done was lovely and beautiful. Everything, the recognition of guests and everything that you've done, the welcome and all. Thank God for my companion. I thank God for this man that the Lord sent here 26 years ago. And when he came and he said the Lord was leading him here, I said, "Well, honey, the Lord told you to go. He didn't tell me." Because I was that space freak and born, and I was happy there and satisfied there. But I don't why. I was like the prophet's son. The Lord had to do a work on me. And when he got through doing that work on me, I was ready to come too. And I tell you on today, I am so glad to be a part of this Kedron family. They have been so special and so dear to me, and I am so blessed, amen, to be here. And I certainly thank God for each and every one of them. I love them all with the love of God. They all touch my life in a special way, but they all have a special place in my heart. And I want you to know, Kedron, I love you and thank you so much. And at this time, I'm going to stop now and let Pastor Sledge come. And whatever I forgot and left off, he'll pick it up. Bring it up.
God bless you today. We certainly give honor to the Lord today and to each and every one of you. We started this song last year to do this halfway into the service. So because sometimes people leave before we get a chance to thank you for being here. And we really want to thank you for coming because we realize you didn't have to do it, but you did. And we appreciate you so much for coming. And so we started doing this halfway in the service. As Sister Tish was saying, we're certainly standing in prayer for the Griffin, Ross family, the Williams family, lost a brother last week, and also the Phillips family. We're standing in prayer that God will continue to strengthen them as the days to come. We're certainly giving honor to God and to our district superintendent, to the Speaker of the Hour, Ella Hart. We're anticipating a word from the Lord. Amen. We just believe that we have something that God is going to give you for today to be a great blessing to our church. Amen. We thank God for Pastor Sutter, Pastor Bird, Pastor Sled, Pastor Spirit, our district superintendent. We have your superintendent. He is superintendent. God bless. Superintendent Oliver. Amen. God bless Ella Phillips, Pastor Martin, and all of their beautiful wives. Amen. That are here. We thank God for all of these great men of God. As Sister Smith said earlier, we can't thank Kedron enough.
Amen.
Amen. Because you do this all year long. You just don't do it right today. But all through the year, you see about the Sledge and the Sledge family. We appreciate you so much. We thank you for all that has been done on today, all the beautiful the finance that you give, and also the choir. Let me say this. Those that are singing and those that are they rehearse hard. I mean, they come through, they practice and practice and practice. And I told them the other day when they were getting on the van, I said, it's going to be sure enough something. All that practice y'all have done. We thank God. They done a beautiful job today. Amen. Thank God for Pastor Martin. Thank God. I don't want to go back over to the stage and say it. I just thank God for our children. Amen. And all that's present in the house of the Lord today, we love it, each and every one of you. Amen. We appreciate you so much for coming. And we just feel that God is going to come.
something different. Yeah. I'm going to do the different. Because that's what I see you doing. And I can say about Pastor Hobbs that that's what he does. He leads and has been for 41 years by example. And he does so in grapevine. That's what he does. The spirit in his house makes the difference in his life, which falls on fruitful ground, and I'm the recipient of the fruitful ground. So I can produce after what, because I'm a production of, and I can continue to produce on. Sheep beget
sheep.
Preachers beget
preachers.
Missionaries beget. Y'all see where I'm going with this. Without further ado, I introduce the song and present to others, none other than Pastor Lawrence Everloving Hobbs.
Speak a word to your people that they may be blessed. That when we go down from this place, we will.
I say, all of my brothers in the gospel and all of the first ladies, amen, and thank God for my own companion of almost 49 years. Amen. Son out of 8 children, 4 boys, 4 girls. Amen. She's the mother of 4 boys, 4 girls, 16 grands, and 8 great grands. That's still living. Hey, wait a minute, y'all. Y'all doing all that clapping? I don't look too bad. Amen. We thank God today. Thank God for Pastor Sledge and Lady Sledge, and who was with us.
Praise God.
Amen. In June, I believe, June or July, and he preached, the man preached.
Yes.
A great preacher, great man of God. You are honoring a great man of God. And we come to celebrate these 26 years, amen, with Kedron. With Kedron. Now the sun is still up and I don't want to preach till the moon come out. So I'm going to go right on into the word. And we try to, amen, center something around the theme. Let us submit to God and don't quit. A good theme, a real
yes,
theme.
Yes, sir.
Thank God for great back. Great back stand. Out with us,
yes.
Amen, to help make up this, amen, celebration.
Yes.
Turn your Bibles, if you will, to Hebrew chapter 13. And I'm going to talk in brief, amen, from that passage of scripture and maybe a few others as the Lord will. Now, let me warn you. I don't intend to be long, because when I went back to the room of rest, they must be cooking some greens. My. So I'm gonna have to cut across the brain. I don't know who's cooking those greens before they smell like
that. Amen.
Ah, Lord, today. So we want to talk a little bit today from the subject of submit yourselves unto the Lord and don't quit. Hebrew chapter 13, verse 17 says, obey them that have the rule over you. And submit yourselves, for they watch for your souls, as they must give account, that they may do it with joy and not with grief, for that is unprofitable for you. And my subtopic is no time to quit. No time to quit. But we think in terms of the word submit, it has the meaning, as I looked it up, to yield. To yield. And I find in these days and times that we're living in, not many people want to be submissive.
That's right.
Right. Many people want to yield. And you really have to have humility to submit.
That's right.
Amen.
Because there is an entity, there is a spirit that ride upon people to reject submissiveness or reject the yielding to God. If we're going to submit to anybody, we have to submit to God. It's hard to be submissive to your leader if you're not submissive to God. Because there is an entity, there is a spirit that sometimes makes us feel like I am he, or I am better than he. Now, listen to me closely. There are sometimes people feel, Pastor, that I can do it better.
That's right.
But I've never gone through what you've gone through. They feel like they can do it better, First Lady, but not in Kedron.
It's not happening. You know, they don't think that in y'all church.
But there is a spirit that always feels that they can do it better. If God didn't call you to do a thing, you can't do it. And if you got anything to do it, you'll make a mess. When God calls you to do a thing, He fixes you, He equips you, He intertwines, He tangles you up in Him. You become balled up in Him to do what He called you to do. It takes prayer. It takes fasting.
Yes.
It takes seeking the face of God, because the Bible declares in Jeremiah 29:11, 12, and 13, we used to use 11. I know the thoughts that I think for you. Thoughts of good.
Yes.
Thoughts of peace.
Yes.
Not of evil to give you an expected end. So we love that part. But when we go down, He says, and then you shall seek me. When you can find me, when you shall find me. And 90% of the time, when God wants to use us, He will humble us.
Yes.
I used to pray, Lord, humble me for your service. I don't pray that anymore. Because God has ways that He can humble you. God has ways that He can humble you. He can allow something to attach itself to you. He can allow a problem to come your way, and that thing will humble you. It will cause you to cry out like you've never cried out before. It will cause you to pray like you've never prayed before. It will cause you to seek God like you never sought God before. For I just said, God, I humble myself because of this. Humble yourself before the man. He doesn't do it ourselves. If we do what He said do, He'll do what He said He'll do. Understand, God wants us to be submissive. He wants us to submit to Him. What are you talking about, Brother Howard? When I become submitted to God, then I'm yielding my all to God. As Paul said, it is no more, but it is Christ that liveth in me. And the life that I now live, I live it by the faith of the Son of God. Love me, Galatians 2:20. So when I submit to God, then I'm giving Him my all. That means I'm not keeping any of it. It's not like the man says that if I had $300, Lord, I'd give you $100, I'll give the church $100, I'll give $100 to the poor. So the Lord bless him to find $300. And he found $300. The story said he found $300 and he says, you know, Lord, I said I would give $100 to the church. You know I am the church. Lord, you know I did say I would give $100 to the poor. I was poor before I found this. And I said I would keep $100. And he realized that all he said he would do, he brought it up on himself to keep the $300. When you're submitted to God, you realize everything that you have. Even that which you blessed the pastor and Lady Sledge with today is not theirs.
That's right.
What do you mean, Pastor? We gave it to them. What you gave to them was not yours.
That's right.
Because everything you have belongs to God. And when you give it to them, it's still God. God just bless you to give to them to be good stewards or what they have. So when we submit ourselves to God, we're telling God, all that I am belongs to you. All that I have belongs to you. All that I get is mine, and you give to me to give to others. So when I become submitted Rolls Royce.
Yeah.
Still gotta live right.
Yeah.
So if I'm going to be submitted to someone, I'm going to be submitted to a holy God.
Yes.
Oh, I know the Bible says submit yourself one to another. Wife, be submitted to your husband.
Yes.
But when I get through submitting to you, I yet got to be submitted to God.
Amen.
Yes.
Yes.
And don't quit.
Yes.
I've not seen it so often as I see it now.
Jesus.
Should I say saints? Should I say Christians? Should I say people that call themselves saints? Or should I? Should I say people that are testifying? I'm saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. How should I say it? Because as soon as trouble arrives, they throw in the towel. I'm so mad, but I have a mind quick. I'm so mad, but I have a mind to throw in the towel. Not only have a mind to throw in the towel, but sometimes throws in the towel. And the God that saved you, the God that brought you up out of your mess, he didn't bring you up and out to quit to go back in.
Sometime in the late hours of the night, you may be seated. Sometime in the early hours of the night, he knows how to talk to you. Sister Persimmon, she had to learn. Don't worry about it, because Sister Campbell, she gonna talk to Sister Persimmon, and they gonna cohorse against you. But don't worry about it. I pray for you. I give you strength.
Yeah. Yes.
We're being tested like never before.
Yes.
Revelation chapter 12 says the devil knows he has but a short time.
Yes.
And because he has but a short time, what is he doing? He's working on the saints.
Yes.
He's not working on the club horse. He's not working on the crackhead. He's not working on the dope smoker. He's working on the child of God that loves Jesus.
Something
that no other man can do.
That's right.
Do we have any singles in here? Single women or single men? Prayers.
I didn't say I'm lifting a hand. I said my prayers. That's all right, Pastor. That's all right. I talked to the lady, and maybe the lady says, I don't understand. Honey, if God give you to do it. And I'm here talking about submitting unto the Lord. Don't quit. God give it to it, honey. Feel at liberty to do it. Go for it. We'll pray for you. We got your back in prayer.
Yeah.
The first month, it seems good. It seems glorious. The second month, it seems glorious. Oh, my God. You all know God gave me blase, blase. And I'm so happy. I'm so blessed. I feel joy down in my living room. The next 2 or 3 weeks, the problems fall out of it. And you wonder why. You want me to tell you why?
Right.
Because when God bless you these 3 or 4 weeks and everything was going good, that was an entity sitting on the background. We'll fix this. Start whispering in the mind. Nobody's around when you start whispering in the mind. I wonder why nobody's helping me. I wonder why, I wonder why, I wonder why, I wonder why. Then you find yourself slipping out of submission.
I got it.
Slipping out of your commitment.
Yes.
Now you're in the doorway of quitting. Quitting is not an option.
That's right.
God didn't bring you out of place you somewhere for you to quit.
Yeah.
If you quit, you're quitting on your own.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, he knows how to beat your tail. Y'all forgive me if that was offensive to some of y'all. He knows how to beat your backside. He said, because if you can't stand chastisement, you're not a son.
Healing Jesus.
for that man, for that woman, for that boy, that girl. And I call those things that are not as though they were. Woman, be healed. Man, be healed. Be set free. Be delivered. Be delivered.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is for you. Pastor, we always see him suited up. He got half pants closed.
Thank you.
I said something.
Yeah.
That is encouraging. What is wrong?
trying to be on you, and I'm just trying to encourage us.
Yeah.
Because I'm in this boat too.
Yeah.
Glory be to God. I'm in this Titanic.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. The Titanic started going down, paddle me to the bank. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you for your goodness. We thank you, dear God, and I pray, God, that you will satisfy us with the word that you allow us to share with your people. And Father, if I've spoke anything that was displeasing and offensive to you, I said before your people, you forgive me.
Yes.
Holy Spirit, if I offended, vexed, or grieved you in any way today, I ask your forgiveness.
Yes.
For I want my life to be pleasing in your sight.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Now, Father, I pray that you would bless and sanctify the food. Bless those that prepared it in the hands of David.
Yes.
Let it be nutritious to the body.
Yes.
This we ask in Jesus' name. Thank God.
Thank God.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. God bless you.
Amen.